It really is an exciting time for us at Heart, having read this very heartwarming story in the Observer about Acacia and her son Joshua, and the fact that it has renewed hope that is fading about what the Jamaican society is all about and the good values that we still have in our society. And Acacia, we want to say thank you for choosing to do the right thing. Thank you for setting a good example for Joshua to follow.
You took a stance amidst the pressure, family, friends, and you did what is right. And you stood up for what you believed in, which is excellent. You represent, to me, a true Jamaican. Proud, honest, forthright, never change. You have spoken, and we heard you. You said that you wanted a scale, and we are here to act. We're committed to help you to achieve that. We are the Human Capital Development, and you represent a true, true Heart trainee in the new Jamaica that we're trying to build. So proud of you.
You make our jobs so easy. We work with so many young people, and there are so many negative messages that are surrounding our Jamaican youth now. So we are so heartened to sell and to promulgate your message, because it is indeed a message that we want the young people to be attached to. Just to say that Acacia, she has started her assessment. We want to see what level she is, so we can do the necessary assessment to get her up to the standard where she's going to be doing training. If she's ready for training, we are going to be facilitating the application process so that immediately you can now get into a program.
When I read your story, Acacia, the first thing that came to me was that you did this as a knee-jerk reaction. You didn't think about it. You see the bag of money in the place, and you see what she said to me when I spoke to her on the phone, "It is not my money." And she took it to the police station. That kind of knee-jerk reaction, without thinking about the, you know, how you could enrich yourself, the long-term rewards that you might get from having a bag of life cash, that knee-jerk reaction where you felt that it was the right thing to do, showed the level of integrity and honesty that you have as a very young woman. You're 23 years old, and a young woman who is not, well, you know, you're not rich. You're living day-to-day and trying to make ends meet. So one of the things that we'll do with Acacia's permission is to set up a GoFundMe account so that the Jamaicans who are abroad can be able to contribute easily. And for you and Joshua, I just want to say I am very inspired, very proud to see that we have young people who are in the inner city who are able to stand up and be counted, and we are here to support you. I have already pledged, and we will ensure that we provide you with the kind of assistance financially that Heart NTA and the team are also putting in place. I want to big up Heart for coming on board so quickly and for putting their what we like to say in Jamaica, the money where the mouth is.
I really appreciate everything from my heart. God has opened some doors for me, and I hope I inspire someone out there, young like myself too. I never can tell, because I have children out there that are going through a harder phase than me.
Thank you all, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the support, and let us continue to do the right things, to do good, and to remind Jamaicans who may have doubt that there's still a lot of hope and there's still a lot of good things happening in Jamaica that we all can be proud of.